had 14 kids and this was one of them. So I'll try to begin with the Delhi gate and give you a basic layout of the city. Delhi gate is the one through which you, if you're coming down Bahadur Shah Zafar Marg, you enter Delhi from there. That was called Delhi Darwaza because if you went out of that gate, you went to Delhi. Delhi was Mehroli. And Red Fort had two gates, Delhi Darwaza and Lahori Darwaza. The Delhi Darwaza is to the south and that was used by the royalty. And the Lahore Darwaza was used by the common people. If you came out of Lahore Darwaza and walked absolutely straight, you will go out of the Lahore Darwaza of Delhi and continue in that direction, you will reach Lahore. That is how these. Cities, most of them rose one day. So Delhi Darwaza, then next was Turkman Darwaza, which is not named after a place but after a Sufi who is buried inside. Not the small little grave outside, which is, has nothing to do with him. He is buried inside, Shah Turkman Biyabani. He died the same year as Razia Sultan died. That area became a graveyard because he was buried there. Razia Sultan is also buried there. So Delhi Darwaza, Turkman Darwaza, Ajmeri Darwaza, Kabuli Darwaza, Lahore Darwaza, Mori Darwaza, from where the dirty water of the city went out. That was called Mori Gate. Originally it was known as Badraw Darwaza, bad stream, bad drain. And the water came out into an open space and there it was soaked into the ground. That is where the solid waste of the city was also buried. So Mori Darwaza, after that Kashmiri Darwaza, then Nigambo Darwaza, it was somewhere here, not where it is currently located. Then there was Kela Ghat Darwaza, Bela Ghat Darwaza, Nigambod Ghat Darwaza, Kela Ghat Darwaza, Bela Ghat Darwaza. Then there was Pani Darwaza, there was Patthar Ghati Darwaza, then there was Raj Ghat Darwaza, and then you are back at Delhi Darwaza. Kolkata Darwaza was added by the British because when Shahjahanabad was built, there was no Calcutta. It was at Kolkata Darwaza that the telegraph office was located. 1640. 1640 was also a very heavy monsoon and most of the wall broke down. So they realized that this is not very good defense. So it had to be built with stone. Now the perimeter of the city is about, 13 or 14 kilometers. So itna patthar kahan se aayega? Outside there was a deserted city, the city of Firoz Shah Tughlaq. So it was cannibalized. That is why Firoz Shah Tughlaq's Kotla Firoz Shah is in such a bad state, because stone was removed from there and this was used for building the boundary. But between 1640 and the time when the British took over, 1803 after the Battle of Patpadganj, where General Lake defeated the Marathas, then the British took over the city. Most of the walls were in a very bad shape. After they had defeated the Marathas, the Britishers were convinced that the Marathas are going to regroup and attack again. So they strengthened the defenses of the city. So this part of the wall, when we go on the other side, you will see this. You see these stones? They are all being cut into rectangular shape. This is not how it was originally built. This was additions built by the British. When we go on the other side, you will also see they created placements for cannons. In 1804, Holkar regrouped and attacked Delhi, and Delhi, the British were able to defend the city because they had strengthened the defences. In 1857, the Britishers were outside and trying to get into the city from Kashmiri Gate, which they had strengthened 50 years ago. So, and that is why, you know, the major battle to get into Kashmiri gate happened in this, because they were on the ridge and from there they were attacking. We'll go to the other side and then I'll tell you how it happened. So originally this did not have two doors. When the British strengthened it, they added two doors to it. If you go around the other gates, all of them are single entry doors. This became a door with two entries, or one entry, one exit. Till the time that I was in college, DTC buses used to ply under this. So they will go out this way and they'll enter the city from here. Yes.
Here?
6972, before this ISBT came up. This was an open place, garden and all that. And I was telling you there were 14 gates. Next to each gate there was a wicker gate. And outside where we are standing there was a moat. Water flowed around the city, outside the city, through a moat which was about 15 feet or 19 feet broad and about 20 feet deep. Water entered the city from outside Mori Gate, went all around the city and fell back into the Jamna at the Rajghat Darwaza. So then it's been filled up and all that. So the road to Delhi University used to go this way. Now when the British were trying to recapture the city, they were driven out on the 11th of May, and from the 12th or 14th of September the attack on Delhi began. Three months later, and there were two massive wooden doors, and they couldn't get in. They were constantly firing cannons at it, and all these holes that you see, these are all where the cannon ball struck. But they were the gate still held, and defenders of the city were all on this wall and they were constantly shooting at them. Then, taking advantage of darkness, they sent some soldiers with bags of gunpowder, which were stacked near the door, near the closed door. And then they kept on aiming their fire at the bags of gunpowder, and one of them caught fire and it exploded, and that is when the door flew off, and then the British moved in 16th of September 1857. So this is the place where the battle took place. There is this stone which gives the names of the brave soldiers who died in taking Kashmiri Gate. And some of the names have eroded at the base, but all of them have been replaced there. So you can read the names of the... There is not a single name of those who were defending the gate. That is how we kept records. So we don't know. We don't know who were the people, who were the soldiers, etc., etc. Behind this is St. James Church. When the British were trying to recapture this gate, they were throwing, they were firing cannonballs, and their aim was not very good. So many of them fell on St. James Church and the dome broke very bad. On top of the dome, there was a huge brass ball. And for the 3 months when the rebels were holding the city, they were just hanging around. So they tried to perfect their aim. So they used to keep on shooting at that brass ball, and in the middle of the night you will hear ping, one bullet hits. When they restored the entire structure, they removed that brass ball, and it was displayed in front of St. James Church for many years. then somebody stole it. Look at it. I've seen it as a child, it was displayed outside, it's no longer there. So, and then the entire this church was restored later, etc. So this is where the major battle for Kashmiri took place, and this is where the soldiers entered. Now you can see this wall that is built by the British. This wall turned around, and where our bus is parked, you can see the bits of the wall that continues there. This wall was intact till the 70s. When they decided to build the ISBT, they built this road, extended this road. Otherwise, the Lothian road used to come out of here. So they changed the direction and they broke that wall, and then ISBT came, and then this monstrosity came. I don't know how it was permitted to come up here. It is less than 50 meters from the Kashmiri Gate, which is a protected monument. So the kind of violence that the metro has done to heritage in the city is unbelievable.
I think it's because, like, any heritage rules, like, if they claim that it's for national importance, then it can override those heritage rules. This, national importance.
No, this amendment has been brought about 2 months ago. It didn't exist.
Is this in retrospect? Yes.
So they have allowed this.
This to happen, and yes, now in retrospect, created an amendment.
Now the game is totally different. Because now with this amendment, they can build a flyover next to Humayun's tomb. They can build it anywhere. They'll say this is of national importance.
So how was this built?
The metro was given, you know, all over the world, metro is underground.
And to make money.
They have a mall here. Why? You know, why was metro given so much land? So, but in those days, I was telling you, there was a wicker gate. This was the wicker gate. And as a child, when I went in the morning for a walk in Nicholson Garden, we went out this way. We came out of here. I was born in this street. Nicholson Road. So you went out from here and you would enter the wall. And when at night all the gates will be closed. So anybody who was late and did not enter the city before sunset, he has to stand and holler, darwaza kholo, darwaza kholo. Then a guard will come and he will identify him. If he identifies him, knows him, he'll open the gate. Otherwise, he has to say, "Main us ghar mein rehta hoon, wahan se kisi ko bula ke le aao, koi aake pehchanega." So only when you are identified that you have bona fide reasons to be inside the city.
Ancient tradition nahi chalta. Haan?
Wo bhi chalta hoga, wo bhi chalta hoga. Wo kam nahi chalta tha. Wo to Mahabharat ke samay chal raha. Hamari parampara ka hissa. Prachin parampara ka hissa. So, actually there is this very interesting post that has come from New Zealand about why there is corruption in India. And they say that the very idea that you can commit as many sins as you want, but before death you give a big donation to a temple. So you know, you can negotiate with gods to get into heaven. So then what is left, you know? You can negotiate anything.